Hi, welcome to I Wanna Make. I'm gonna try and use AI to narrate this. Bye.
This video documents my build process for Robotic Reflections, my latest kinetic sculpture. I built it for an art night at the WeWork I go to, and it's now showing at the Emerging Artists Gallery at DTLA Art Night. My first idea was tiny robotic arms with LEDs on them inside an infinity mirror. I mocked these up and submitted them and got into the first event. I realized that 6 robot arms with 4 degrees of freedom would take at least 12 motors, so wondered how I could combine movements using fewer motors. I started looking at different mechanical movements, see 507movements.com for a wonderful resource, and became fascinated with linkages. I stumbled upon a Hoberman mechanism and fell in love with it, and decided to use that. I documented how I designed and 3D printed the Hoberman mechanism in my shorts. My first try wasn't successful, but eventually I figured out that it uses 12 identical bent parts in a scissor mechanism, and I was able to both simulate it using revolve joints in Fusion 360 and make it in real life. At first I used screws and nuts as joints, but those would unscrew themselves. Eventually I used 3mm binding screws, otherwise known as Chicago butt screws. The Hoberman mechanism can be driven with just one motor, and it takes little effort to drive it. However, there is no fixed point that remains stationary. That was a challenge because in order to mount the mechanism in the art, if I used a stationary mounting point, the whole mechanism would shift as it opens and closes. I tried using springs to mount the mechanism, and that ended up being the best solve. It was important to me for the motor to be as silent as possible. I've seen and built kinetic sculptures where noise is part of the experience, but I wanted this one to be silent. That ruled out servos, so I used a stepper motor, an Arduino CNC shield, and a Big Tree Tech stepper driver. Side note, the Big Tree Tech TMC2208 is a drop-in replacement for the A4998 step stick, but its spin-out looks upside down compared to the step stick. I first put it in backwards. I designed my own motor flange and actuator in Fusion 360 and 3D printed them. This took several tries to get the right fit and ratio. I also designed a mount for the stepper motor. Some of my mechanical designs called for the motor to go back and forth, but since the flange and actuator turns the motion linear, I didn't have to worry about the microcontroller knowing the stepper motor's position or having to use end stops to calculate it. The circuit is pretty simple. I'm using a 12 volts 3 amp power adapter and used a calculator online to set the driver's current for the 1.5 amp motor. I then have it 12 to 5 volt DC converter to power the LEDs and microcontroller, which can power 3 amps. I'm using a TNC2 to send pulses to the motor. Even though they're old, I prefer the 5 volts logic on those, and I wasn't doing anything complicated except sending pulses. For the hexagonal build, I found some hexagonal mirrors to use as the frame. I still had to make the semi-reflective one-way mirror. Is it a one-way mirror or two-way mirror? I have no idea. I found a tutorial on WikiHow that recommended using automotive reflective tint, and this one worked well. I used Windex instead of soap and a credit card instead of a squeegee to apply the tint. Cutting glass into a hexagon was above my skill set. I tried scoring and breaking a pane of glass watching some YouTube tutorials, and it didn't go well. I ended up ordering a custom pane of glass from a glass manufacturer, and it ended up being one of the most expensive parts. I needed a box to fit the motor and circuitry in, and was going to make a rectangular one but decided to use half of one of the leftover hexagonal mirrors. This looked aesthetically more pleasing and makes the whole thing look like an abstract plant to me. I still had to cut holes for the actuator and LEDs and make a cover for the box. I used two kinds of LED lights, adhesive strips that went around the frame of the sculpture, and LED string lights that I zip-tied to the Hoberman sculpture with enough slack for it to still move. I ended up using the LED controllers that came with the lights instead of running them from the TNC. The first art show went okay. I finished epoxying the mirror to the frame on the day of the show, so didn't have much time to QA it. The sculpture worked fine for about 3 hours, and then started clicking and stopped moving. The motor got too hot and melted my flange enough for it to break. It also melted and warped the motor mount. I disconnected the motor and had to run it with just the lights for the rest of the night. I got into the next dart show and was determined to make the art longer lasting. I found a geared stepper motor with the same current, which should be a drop-in replacement, except it had different dimensions, so I had to remake the base, motor flange, actuator, and motor mount. Hexagons are hard to make. Most of the saws I have can't cut at the 60-degree angle I needed. I had to sand the angles to 60 degrees, which was less precise. Gluing and clamping at angles were a challenge too. I had to make a jig to make sure the platform was level while gluing, and adapters to allow me to clamp the angled walls. My first stepper mount had zigzag pieces that were very difficult to print. In my next print, I separated the mount into three pieces with clips to easily print and attach to the motor. I also made several more versions of the flange to make the least amount of work for the motor. I also tried using a CNC service, send cut send, to cut the actuator out of steel, since my 3D printed one bent as well. They were affordable and shipped the parts quickly to me. After I assembled everything, I tested it for a few hours, and the new motor still got hot running all the time. So I added a connection to the enable pin and changed my code so that the motor would run a full cycle in 8 seconds, and then disable for 15 seconds. This lower duty cycle kept the motor cool and it could run for days. The DC 5 volt converter also was getting hot running all of the LEDs. I tried turning the LED brightness down and that solved it. Both the motor and converter now are as cool as a cucumber. I also added some grease to the actuator. With all of that done, Robotic Reflections should run way longer.
Thanks for watching. I update this channel like once a year, so subscribe.